may be seated. At this time, I would like to introduce our senior class president, Kirkland Thomas.
Good afternoon, everyone. I've had the honor of serving as the president of the class of 2019. We are here today before family and friends, ready to take on our future. It's not a distant reality anymore. It begins here and it begins today. How do we measure the time we spent in high school? In the beginning, we measured it in class periods, counting down the day to our freedom. As time passed, we measured it in semesters, sporting events, exciting school functions, holiday breaks, homecomings, and proms. And now here we are graduating class of 2019. Our rule at Chelsea High School is over, and it's time to pass the torch on to the next class. I know that as I look out on all of you, I will measure my time here by all the wonderful friendships, experiences, and memories I have made. As each of us walk across the stage and leave today, we will all carry with us a little bit of Chelsea High. Today is a day to celebrate. We have made it and we should be proud, but we couldn't have done it without our parents, teachers, family, and supporters, and we are forever grateful and thankful for you. Today is about more than graduation. Today is a celebration of the life you're living, the discoveries you're making, and the challenges you're meeting. Face your future and those challenges with your head held high and heart wide open. As I close, I would like to leave you with this verse from Isaiah 10:31. But those who hope in the Lord will renew their strength. They will soar on wings like eagles. They will run and not grow weary. They will walk and not be faint. Cherish these years and these years to come. Thank you. It's a great day to be a Hornet and War Eagle. Just kidding. Please join Ella Grace Griffin, Senior Class Vice President, as she leads us in reciting the Pledge of Allegiance.
Would you stand? Attention, salute, pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may be seated.
Good afternoon. My name is Wayne Trux. I'm the principal at Chelsea High School, and I want to welcome each and every one of you to our commencement exercises for the day. The Chelsea High School faculty and staff represent many years of service and dedication to education. Our teachers are involved, motivated, and caring. We are proud of the many contributions our faculty members have made to the lives of our graduates, and we would like our faculty to please stand so that they can be recognized. Ms. Wilson, it was only 4 years or 5 years that you were in this crowd, right? Six? Ten? Congratulations, Ms. Wilson. We'd also like to recognize our Chelsea High School professional educators and staff, as well as all of Chelsea High School alumni who are here in attendance, to stand at this time to be recognized. High fives all around. Many of us remember the days when we had this in the gym, right? A little bit better here, just a little, maybe, okay? I would also, before we continue, like to recognize any past, present, or planned members of the military so that we may thank you for your service. Logan, Tyson. I would now like to introduce James Berryhill, who will be singing a special song for us. Thank you.
And our places I remember all my life. Though some have changed, some forever, not for better. Some have gone, and some remain. All these places have their moments with people and things that went before. Some are dead, some are living. In my life, I love you all. But of all these friends and lovers, there is no one compared with you. And these memories lose their meanings when I think of love as something new. Though I know I'll never lose affection for people and things that went before, I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love them all. Affection for people and things that went before. I know I'll often stop and think about them. In my life, I love them all. In my life, I love you all.
Thank you, James. I would now like to invite our 2019 salutatorian, Ms. Allie Brasher, to the podium to deliver the salutatorian address.
Dearly beloved, we are gathered here today not to mourn the end, but to celebrate the life of your student's school career. It lived a good 13 years, but it's over. A new chapter is starting, and I think we, Chelsea High School's class of 2019, are ready for it. Not based solely on the merit of our high school education, but the character each student has developed and the skills they have chosen to nurture. We all have paths before us. Some know exactly what they want, others don't. But we will all be surprised by what we encounter along the way. Getting to be our class's salutatorian was a pleasant surprise. I've always worked hard, but I didn't realize my efforts had paid off how they did. I'm honored to represent the second best our school has to offer. I'm honored for this to be part of my story, facing hundreds of people and all of my anxieties at the same time. Stories are a simple way of explaining life. It breaks life down so it's easier to understand the scope of it. One of my favorite quotes from Doctor Who explains this well. We're all stories in the end, just make it a good one. I don't know about everyone here, but overall, high school has been a good story. For the sake of this speech, I am slightly romanticizing my experience, acting like the almost constant stress wasn't a major part of my story. I know many of my close friends and peers have been under the same insurmountable weight, but the weight of AP classes and looming exams are over. Hooray! Until we start college and into the cycle all over again, double hooray. I remember being excited to start high school. During eighth grade, I had back surgery, which put me out of school for about half of the year. So getting into the new group of high school was exciting. Back then, I wasn't excited for the end of an era. I was excited for the beginning. And I can say, without a doubt, I'm at least 10 times more excited for the new chapter in my life to begin. To me, freshman year was slow, but a blur at the same time. I only seem to remember the highlight reel of what happened. Sophomore year, probably Wynn's hardest year. They just had to pair algebra with trig in chemistry. Junior year was the best happenstances. All of my classes were fun, all of them alive with people bonding over how we all made the decision to take such hard classes. But to me, senior year has definitely been the fastest slow year. Fast because I could have sworn yesterday was the first day of school, getting confused by the new layout of the school and managing to break my new water bottle during fourth period. But still slow as I struggled to pick which college to go to. I now can't wait to join Birmingham Southern class of 2023. And the reality setting in of the fact that this will be the last time I see some of the people I've seen almost every day since I was 5. People always try to paint endings as sad, but I can assure you that is not the case. As an avid reader, I've experienced some of the saddest endings books have to offer. But for every sad one, there's a happy one. One full of hope, excitement, and even a good mystery to make sure a story stays with you even after you finish it. I highly doubt high school will leave you with mysteries to solve, but hopefully it will leave you in better shape than it found you. Because to me, that is the point of all stories, to take you on a journey and leave you in a better place than it started you in. A story isn't complete without people to make sure the main character makes it to the end. Without them in the story, the hero fails. So, to the people in my life that have helped me get this point, I thank you. My friends, family, and teachers, especially my mom and dad. Without you, I would have broken down and given up a long time ago. I know they are just as happy as I am that I have made it to this new chapter of my life. No matter the parts of high school I have enjoyed or the parts I have hated, it has been a well-rounded experience. I'm glad to have been a part of this class. To my friends that have had to learn the hard way that when I want to be, I can be talkative. And to the people I've been going to school with since kindergarten but haven't said a word to, goodbye.
Thank you, Allie. I would now like to invite our 2019 valedictorian, Ms. Ellie Burchell, to the podium to deliver the valedictorian address.
Esteemed guests, parents, faculty, and fellow graduates, I want to start by thanking you all for being here today. Today is the culmination of 4 years of hard work, not only by the graduating class of 2019, but also by everyone sitting here in this room. You've supported us, encouraged us, and walked with us through our high school careers, and for that, we will be forever grateful. To all of the parents, you spent countless hours on the sidelines watching our sporting events. You brought us that important assignment we left sitting on the kitchen counter, speaking from personal experience. You drove us from place to place until we turned 16, and while we can never thank you for that, the most important thing that you did was give us unconditional love and support. That love has given us the confidence to be bold and pursue goals that didn't seem possible. You are all the reason each of us are sitting here today. To the faculty of CHS, thank you for encouraging us, teaching us, and treating us as your own. While it may have not always seemed like we were listening, it was your lessons that helped us to find our passions. You pushed us to be the best that we could be, and today is a testament to the hours of hard work that you put into each of our classes. You have truly made more of an impact than you will ever know. And to the class of 2019, what a bittersweet occasion this is. I think I can speak for most of us when I say that I am so happy to be graduating, but so sad to leave Chelsea High School and the memories that we've made here behind. In the past 4 years, we spent about 720 days at Chelsea. That is equivalent to 5,760 hours, or 345,600 minutes. When you spend that much time in one place, it's kind of impossible for it not to leave an impact on you. I know that we will never forget the incredible times we spent here at Chelsea High School, searching high and low for something absurd to wear during homecoming week, piling onto the bleachers during football games, sometimes so much that they broke, competing in various sports and competitions, yelling our loudest for the spirit stick at pep rallies, and studying our hardest for tests the period before. We have grown up a lot in those 345,600 minutes. We went from scared freshmen who were excited, nervous, and way less cool than we thought we were, to mature seniors who are ready to conquer whatever lies ahead. And all along, we stood together. We supported one another in hard times and celebrated each other's victories. And along the way, we became like a family, and we'll carry that bond wherever life takes us next. Some of us will join the military, some of us will join the workforce, and many of us will move away to further our education. In a few short months, all of us will begin this new and intimidating chapter of our lives. We'll zip up our suitcases and say goodbye to those who have loved, encouraged, and advised us for the past 18 years. And as we make that transition, I want to pose the question, what will you do with the gift that you've got? I recently heard this quote in a TED Talk and thought it was appropriate. I think the word gift can have a couple of different meanings depending on who you ask. It can come in the form of an opportunity, a friendship, or a God-given talent. And I think that sometimes these gifts are what can set us apart. Not for what we have done, but for what we still have to do. Ahead of us is a full life to live and experiences that we have yet to know. Our lives up to this point have been fairly ordered and laid out for us, each year of high school leading to the next. But now we stand with boundless freedom and potential to lead a life that is our own. It is easy to be filled with hope and excitement and say that your life will be great, and it is easy to focus on what is going on right here and right now. But to achieve success, you must strive each day to move forward using the gifts that you have. Success will not always come easy, but that lack of success only becomes failure when you allow it to. 4 years ago, we walked into the brick building that is Chelsea High School, but we're not the same people walking out. In that short amount of time, so much has changed and so many stories were written, and we're all unique in the fact that ours began at Chelsea High School. I want to challenge you not to focus on what you can accomplish, but how you can use your gifts to help others. I think the only thing left to say is congratulations to the class 2019 and to those who helped us get here. And as always, it's a great day to be a Hornet.
Thank you, Ellie. As we prepare to celebrate the achievements of the class of 2019, I'm going to share a few thoughts about our days together at Chelsea High School that began in August of 2015. This year we tried book groups. Jules, Reggie, and Gore suffered with my group, who read All I Really Need to Know I Learned in Kindergarten by Robert Fulghum. The book is a collection of simple essays which reflect thoughts about how to treat others and what to expect from others. The reason why I mention this book is there are several different keys to happiness which most of us learn in kindergarten: share, be a good friend, and appreciate what gifts we have each day. This lesson is re-emphasized by the My Future program that many of you may or may not remember is the My Future program. As principal, one of my favorite times of the year is when we meet with seniors as part of the My Future program. As you remember, the first meeting is always fun because we talk about our dreams and our plans for the future, where we see ourselves now and where we see ourselves in 10 years. Some of our plans are related to a career, some to having a family, some to living anywhere but Chelsea. We also get to share our artistic talents as we draw a picture of our plans for the future, most of which involved a big house and a lot of cash. The second part of the program was in November with senior interviews, where you had the opportunity to practice your interview skills and share some time with someone who works in a career field you found interesting. Most of you mentioned that that was the most beneficial part of the My Future program because you had the opportunity to prepare for what will be your future. For us, for our administration, for myself, selfishly, the last part of the program is what I enjoy most, the presentation. For those of you not familiar with the program, we ask students to share their plans for life after Chelsea High School, which begins in about an hour, to share if they believe Chelsea High School has prepared them for the future, and lastly, to share some words of wisdom with their ninth grade self. What would they like to go back and tell themselves before they started high school? You guys remember ninth grade. You traveled in packs of six or seven to be sure you did not get lost in the hallways of the high school. You knew all the answers to all the questions, except for the ones related to English, math, science, and social studies. If someone needed help with their Snapchat story or posting something on Instagram, the important stuff, you were right there to help. I enjoy the reflection associated with this last part of the presentation because most of you actually took the time to remember what it was like as a ninth grader and to appreciate how much you have been able to accomplish since August of 2015. Some of you apologized to me when you should actually apologize to your parents because you've been much more difficult to them than for me. But just remember that everyone in this room is here to celebrate you and hope that you have children just like you. The challenge of sharing these words of wisdom, and there's another Beatles reference for you, James, is not to listen, but to follow the message of those words. For example, many of you shared your thoughts with me, and I wrote several of these down. Be yourself. Be yourself. You're the only you that you've got. It's okay not to know. Remember, as a ninth grader, you were terrified if you weren't part of the clique, part of the group, part of those in the know. It's okay not to know. Speak to someone new every day. I really enjoyed that. I think that was Reagan's, because Reagan doesn't have any problem speaking to anybody, whether she knows them or not. Stay strong. There is always a way to overcome a challenge. This is rude, but many of you are surprised to actually be here. Okay? We cannot express how proud we are of the effort that you have put forth in order to be here today and accomplish something that not everybody accomplishes. Your attitude is noticed, as well as your facial expressions. Find something, anything, that makes you happy. That takes a lot of maturity, that understanding that you have to make yourself happy before you can make anyone else happy. Take advantage of the opportunities given to you. This is a good place. This is a great place, and you've been given a head start that many other students in our area, in our state, and in our country don't have. If you know better, act better. I wouldn't suggest getting a tattoo, but if you're going to get a tattoo, if you know better, act better might be a kind reminder. Happiness lies in the successes in life, but it is mostly about the effort. We all want to be successful, but we also remember the hard work that we put in place in order to achieve that success or near success. And lastly, be kind, which is something that is easy to do, but also difficult to do on a regular basis. These are the statements you shared with me that I'm now sharing with others. The easy part is saying these words, but the challenge is living these words. None of you, not a single one, mentioned that happiness is tied to financial success. Each of you noted that being happy is a choice. Each day we wake up and we can decide if we will be happy that day. Every day we have the opportunity to make a positive difference in the lives of others. If we reflect for just a moment, we can identify a time when a kind word or a smile has made a positive difference for each of us. So, as our time together comes to an end, let me repeat what we already know. Each day is an opportunity. Each day is an opportunity to be happy if we choose to be happy, because each day and every day is. Congratulations to the class of 2019. Before the presentation of diplomas, we want to remind friends and families of our graduates to please hold their applause until all of the seniors' names have been read. We believe that each one of these young men and women deserve the dignity and honor to hear their name and receive the diploma in an appropriate manner. Graduation is an important and formal ceremony, so on behalf of the class of 2019, I respectfully ask you to show your pride and support for these outstanding students by refraining from noise during the presentation of diplomas. I would now like to ask Ms. Kirkland Thomas, president of the senior class of 2019, to join me at the podium.
Would the class of 2019 please stand? Mr. Trucks, I now present the class of 2019 as candidates for graduation.
I accept the presented class of 2019 as candidates for graduation from Chelsea High School. Please be seated.
Ellison Caroline Burchell. Allie Grace Brasher. Reagan Elizabeth Young. Madeline Elizabeth Cavender. Colin Christopher Heisler. Alexandria Nicole Duca. Abigail Lee Woodruff. Hannah Mai Nguyen. Jacob Paul McGuire. Kaylee Michelle McIntyre. Josephine Elizabeth Thomas. Lindsay Michelle Berger. Kristen Lindsay Cates. Julia Elizabeth Ferlisi. Haley Drew Clemens. Riley Elizabeth Conley. Claire Marie Guillen. Alexandria Sarah Dennis. Kyla Marie Cinco Pulisak. Caden O'Neill Christian. James Calvin Berryhill. Turner Cole Griffin. Emily Catherine Johnson. Allison Carol Bishop. Caleb Elijah Tyndall. Rachel Jane Moore. Morgan Lee Williamson. Alexis Nicole Sirio. Zachary Sloan Haskins. Caitlin Latrice Fisher. Hunter Scott Thompson. Noah Christopher Lee. Sarah Mae Blevins. Nathan Michael Trent. Allie Grace Griffin. Samuel Connor Griffin. Brittany Nicole Cummins. Benjamin Stephen Barrett. Matthew Scott Fant. Matthew Salvatore Lanzi. Liam Lotz Wright. Bradley Jacob Tadeo Orozco. Reggie Mar Samaros Lagman. Andrew Michael Lord. Skylar Renee Poling. Rachel Marie Turner. Brianna Lynn Jones. Olivia Cicely Haskin. Taylor Lindley Stafford. Kashace Diane Jackson. Chloe Melania Adams. Duncan Jacob Alder. Francesca Sophia Aragon. Michael Chandler Ard. Kendall Sutton Arnold. Nicholas James Ayers. Jordan Allen Thomas Bailey. Reagan Nicole Bailey. Skylar McKenzie Baker. Burton Hanford Baldwin III. Andrew Morgan Bartleski. Desmond LaShawn Battle. Ashley Lauren Bean. Tucker Scott Beavers. Joel Mitchell Beck. Christopher Alexander Black. Richard Logan Brasher. Autumn Brooke Brewer. Stephen Thomas Brown. Isabel Grace Browning. Destiny Nee Boy. Joseph Patrick Burback. Dylan Michael Burdick. Cardasia Deanne Burns. Emily Grace Bush. Aaliyah Michelle Caffey. Chase Mitchell Carboni. Tristan Nathaniel Alexander Carley. Lane Allison Carper. Kunal Chandra. Catherine Leanne Cheslock. Kyle Patrick Chris. Jacob Douglas Clayton. Nicholas Carl Clayton. Sierra Grace Cleveland. Millie Rose Cole. Nakia Shanice Coleman. Cody Michael Cooper. Mallory Brooke Cooper. Matthew Dalton Corbell. Luther Fox Creel. Holly Catherine D'Alessandro. Chloe Elizabeth Darden. Madeline Chandler Davis. Peyton Lane Davis. Megan Grace Devers. Olivia Diane Del Bianco. Bao Ya Do. Logan Connor Dotson. Emma Grace Duke. Chloe Grace Idson. Connor Jean Infinger. Garrett Thomas Evans. Stephen Mitchell Fant. Julia Elizabeth Feller. Marianne Yannette Figueroa. Reginald Bernard Fisher. Kennedy Lieja Filippo. Donald Nolan Forehand. Bailey Elizabeth Fortenberry. Eric Vladimir Francisco San Martin. Kyle Lane Frangopoulos. Julian Malik Frantz. Patrick Turner Funderburg. Audrey Elizabeth Gilcrease. Reagan Estelle Giles. Clayton Douglas Gilmer. Madison Michelle Goodwin. Joshua Matthew Gore. Joseph Samuel Graham. Matthias Philip Grego. Heath Brian Ganeri. Hunter Lee Ganeri. Tyler James Ganeri. Connor Lee Guess. Muhammad Hamad Hader. Amber Victoria Hallmark. Juliana Danielle Hamer. Olivia Davis Hand. Megan McCarthy Helmley. Aiden Sergio Hernandez. Rachel Elaine Hitson. Christine Hope Hodgins. Catherine Claire Hoffman. Jada Nicole Hope. Georgia Ruth Horn. Cameron Bennett Horton. Lindsay Reed Howard. Camden Scott Wilson Howe. Luke Jack Hunter. Megan Colleen Hurley. Hayden Charles Hutchison. Jordan Alexander Huxhold. Russell Andrew Hyde II. Samuel Burris Ingram. Jalen McKenzie Johnson. Jeffrey Allen Jones II. Todd Lee Justice. Julia Grace Keenum. Christopher Highland Connect. Hannah Noelle Larkins. Avery Preston Lawhorn. Bruce Thuan Lee. Leah Tatum Lyles. Jonathan Lynn. Victor Jawan Lindsay. Hunter Ryan Noble Livingston. Riley Karen Noble Livingston. Holly Elizabeth Lavoy. Niles Jared Macon. Fatima Ruby Maldonado. Addison Denise Marenberga. Joseph Ryan Marlowe. Robert Stephen Marquette. Danya Arlie Martinez. Caleb Benjamin Matzer. Alexis Nicole McAdory. Leandra Elise McAnally. Garrett Walker McLean. Logan Lee McCoy. Anna Grace McDonald. Andrew James Mercier. William Parker Mercier. Madison Elise Milligan. Cheyenne Nicole Mitchum. Christopher Tristan Molina. Edwin Camacho Mondragon. Mary Catherine Montgomery. Madeline Eileen Moody. Marcus Allen Moody. Emma Renee Moore. Julia Susan Moreno. Sarah Nicole Morris. Mackenzie Peyton Mullinax. Brooklyn Nicole Navarre. John Anthony Natuno. Cade Campbell Newberger. Dalton James Nice Wonder. Lando James Nichols. Clara Elizabeth Odom. Parker Roland Odom. Joshua Keith Osborne. Brian Wilson Parker. Rhea Pragnesh Patel. Alexander Joseph Patmalny. Dalton Lee Patterson. William Riley Peacock. Gaston Clark Farr. Cameron Marriott Pierce. Ella Hope Playa. Sarah Elizabeth Clemens. Taylor Kathy Polk. Joel Clark Posey. Wesley Banks Pouncey. Micah Elijah Prince. Savannah Odessa Ray. Bryson Taylor Reedy. Carson Ray Reeves. Marissa Darlene Revel. Austin Tyler Rice. Allison Grace Richard. Jordan Ashley Riggins. Gavin Richard Rigor. Darby Grace Reisner. Nathan Michael Rizzo. Robin Michelle Robertson. Taylor Jean Rushton. Elena Camille Sanders. Michael Vincent Skyra. Maya Alexandria Scott. Madeline Olivia Seboth. Hunter Harrison Selman. Jemiah Simone Shade. Ethan David Shaw. Zachary Christian Shaw. Olivia Ryan Skillern. Ashley Rivers Smith. Brianna Danae Smith. Camden Tennessee Smith. Cameron Elise Smith. Corey Hunter Smith. Stevie Cole Smith. Tyler Wayne Spence. Hakeem Tyree Stanford. Seth Cameron Steele. Caleb Tyler Stevens. Jessica Lynn Stevens. Christopher Kalen Stevens. Ryan Michael Stevens. Carla Nicole Stewart. Haley Michelle Stinson. Zachary Michael Stalker. Kimonte Davon Stover. William Andrew Sullivan II. Sarah Michelle Swee. Ian Garrett Taylor. Jordan Ryan Thames. Julia Marie Theobald. Meredith Arlene Toma. Connor Vandiver Thomas. Kirkland Nicole Thomas. Tatiana Denise Tillman. Jacob Lynn Tennell. Daniela Torres Martinez. Wendy Sarai Torres Nava. Ryan Robert Tripp. Thomas Colton Turner. Matthew Edward Tyson. Kristen Isabella Vetrano. Daniel Jose Villanueva. Adara Jane Vonhorn. E. June Wang. Daniel Jamar Washington. Jakari Trenise Washington. Claire Elizabeth Watts. Addie Savannah Weathers. Haley Ryan Weaver. Tyler Brooks Weber. Carson Scott West. Mackenzie Hatley West. Catherine Ray Wigan. Kristen Faith Whitehurst. Alexis Jewel Williams. Bella Harika Williams. Dalton Andrew Willis. Jaleb Rook Willis. Macy Renee Wise. Cody Matthew Wan. Douglas Charles Wood. Sierra Nicole Woods. Peter Wren III. Stephanie Alexandria Wyatt. Jarek LaVon Youngblood. Emmeline May Zients.
My speech, right? Seniors, if you will please stand. I officially pronounce you 2019 graduates of Chelsea High School. You may move your tassels to the left. Will the audience please rise as James Berryhill leads us in the alma mater. Thank you.